right, guys. DJ, the Guildmaster, with Swilling Gamers Guild, back with another one of our installments for We're Gaming on a Budget. This time we're going over Bolt Action, another one of those World War II games, skirmish game. Unlike Team Yankee and a couple other games like Flames of War, this one's in 28mm scale. I have actually the Band of Brothers starter box out with the Germans and the Americans inside of it. We're gonna, like most of our things, we're gonna go over lore. It's World War II, enough said. This one is fairly fun to play. It's actually relatively cheap once you get there. They have a lot of starter box options. What we're gonna do is we're gonna build a starter army based off of the starter box. So we'll go ahead and we'll get right into it. The starter box is $135. It comes with 12 German infantry, one Hanamag half track, and up to 24 US infantry. Now you can build them a couple different ways. You can build them how the box says. A good combo would be 10-man German squad, light machine gun. And then you have your officer with an extra guy and your Hanamag. The Americans, you could do 10-man, two 10-man squads, one officer with an extra guy, and a bazooka team. What's nice about that box set, it comes with a couple sets of dice, a hunk of terrain. It also comes with the rule book. This is second edition. It's a pretty nice rule book. What's nice about these rule books is they come with all the rules. They also come with base starter stats for all the factions, including all the factions. There's a couple sub factions that aren't in this, such as the Swedes, not Swedes, but the Finns, stuff like that. These actually retail for $40. Something that Warlord Games has done recently is they offer this digitally. So you can either get the hard copy for $40 or a digital copy for $28. I actually kind of like that if you want to go digital. They're not charging you full price. But in the starter, for $135, it comes with everything basically you see here. Now, something that you probably want to do whenever you're building your factions, you can go ahead and get the codexes or the army books. Now, I have both of them here, for one for Germany, one for the United States. Both of these books roughly go for $30, but they're not too awful bad. They'll give you all the generic army listings as well as extra units, and actually these come with the theaters of war. So as you play Bolt Action, similar to Flames of War, they have different eras. You can build Americans based on Normandy landings. You can build Germans based on North Africa. There's all kinds of extra stuff you can do with these. So I definitely recommend picking these up. Breaking down some of the other stuff is, you can go ahead, just like a lot of games, you'll need dice, your D6s. You'll need tape measurers, stuff like that. I've gone over the price of those kind of things in other videos. I'll put a link in the description. One thing this game has, how it plays like a lot of normal skirmish games, but it has alternate activations based on dice. So basically what ends up happening is you get colored dice, one color for each faction. So I actually have gray for Germans and I have green for Americans. What happens is you put these dice into a bag or a hat and you reach in and grab it. And if you grab your appropriate colored dice, then you place it next to a unit and you activate that unit. So it's a back and forth activation. The starter comes with six dice, six for each side. Honestly, you can pick these up, you get 16 dice for $24. If you're running really large armies, or you just want maybe get a different color combination. They have a crap ton of different colors I've seen out there. It's something good to pick up. Makes it a little bit easier for bookkeeping. I won't get too deep into rules, but even though it looks like a normal D6, it has ambush, rally, which are your different unit actions that you can take. So that's $24 for colored dice sets. Now, since we're trying to build a good starter army, the points this game plays, that's 1,000. I'm not too sure about the actual point levels of these, but what I've done is I've grouped them into different things for whenever you build your base army. What's nice about this is you can split this with a buddy. They can take whichever faction. You can kind of build off of it. So we built 2,000-point lists based on the contents of the starter box and adding a couple units. And I actually have the price breakdowns, and I'm visually going to put the units on the table so you guys can get like a better idea of what they look like. So one of the things that you could do for either faction, definitely add in a medium tank. I think it's a pretty good choice, because even this game is based on platoon actions. Sometimes there's a Sherman or a Panzer IV like nearby that can give your platoon assistance. So for the cost of a German Panzer is like $29 right now, and for an M4 Sherman is like $32. Prices vary depending on like what version of a tank you get. So we're going to go ahead and add in Panzer IV. Now they're fairly expensive. They're like 200 points roughly, which takes up a lot of your army, but they're good to have. You have machine guns, the medium gun, the Sherman. Also, you can add to this force, because as it currently stands right now, the Americans have 2 10-man platoons out of the box, a bazooka team, an LT with a submachine gun, and one M4 Sherman. So we're going to build up the Americans first, then we'll build on to the Germans. So the next thing you could probably add to the Americans, medium machine gun. Those usually go for like, depending on price, usually $12.80, so like $13. Now the Americans have a special rule. A lot of times their armies can take two of them, depending on what theater. So you want to add that for like $12. And then build up this force, because a lot of stuff that I've been putting out are like individual purchases or spurs. It's probably good to pick up the American infantry box. You can build 30 infantry out of it. So you can build veterans, you do a lot of stuff. It's for $48 roughly. So you could take that box, add to these two units, because Americans run in 12-man units. So you would just add two more guys to each platoon or each squad, which would then equal 12. Then you could take another 10 guys out of the box and build another infantry platoon or infantry squad with 12 guys. Now when you build them, I suggest building your squads at full strength for one to play, and give all the weapon upgrades. The Americans can take a submachine gun with their sergeant. I suggest taking that in the bar. So there's the other infantry squad. So already we're at three squads with one vehicle and two support. American stuff's pretty cheap. So the other two things you could probably add if you wanted to. You could add a half track. It's like $27. You can use that for ferrying your troops around. So you could add a half track to that. And then the other thing you could add, which I think is a good purchase, is armored cars. For the Americans' case, it's going to be the Greyhound. The one thing you'll notice, the game's actually fairly to scale, believe it or not. Some of these vehicles look super small. In real life, they're fairly tight. Now, used half-track's $27, like I said. The Greyhound is actually $32. You can build a number of ways. You can build it either with the cannon, which we did with the 32 or 37 millimeter, or you can just build it with the machine gun variant. This is like 1,000, or it's actually 998-point American force. As you can see, you get a lot of stuff on the field. The one thing you will find, however, if you would buy that extra box of Americans, that gives you 20 extra guys to play around with. So you can do a couple of different things. Now, could you just go ahead and straight forego the starter box? Buy the rule book and buy a box of Americans, which is actually a little bit cheaper. It'd be like $88. You could definitely do that. But since we're trying to split the starter box with you and another person, this would be a good starting off point. It gives you a lot of flexibility, because you can do different missions where you turn a squad into veterans, and then you could just have your armored car fly around. But with that being said, the two ways you could cost effectively build this. If you'd buy or chip in with a starter box with someone, you're looking at $340 for everything here. Now again, it still gives you 20 extra guys. Now if you were forgo the starter box, buy your rule book, and buy the squad pack of infantry, you're looking at $255. Now, I've also added in $25 for the colored dice, so you can have for that whatever faction you want to play as. Now, as far as like painting supplies goes, you guys have seen my video. For like $30, you get the painting sets, like for Flames of War or Team Yankee, and they're the exact colors you're going to need. They're historic, they're periodically accurate, so you can use them for those miniatures as well as these ones. Also, for another $40, you could pick up the Colors of War, which is also put out by like Osprey, I believe, which helps give you an idea how you want to paint your like your force. To that, you'd be over like at about $420, or you would be like $330 almost, which is really not too bad, getting 1,000 point army, and plus you're going to have extras. You're going to have extra troops. It'll be flexible enough for you to play several games and be okay. Germans are very similar. So obviously what we'll do for the Germans, since we've added the tank with a 10-man squad with three Panzer Schrecks, or Panzer Faust, excuse me, and a Hannah Mag with a lieutenant, to add to that, I think the German force comes up to 1,002 points, which you can go up or down a little bit depending on if your opponent's cool with it. So one thing that we would added would be a German mortar. So that is going to be like $25. German MG42, you would add support, and that's also like $13. Very same price as a American 30 cal. And then for the German air support group, I suggest picking that up for $32. It comes with a lot of the extra stuff. So instead of paying 25 and 15, or excuse me, 13 for your support weapons, 32 gets you an officer, a medic, which is an extra model, FO, and it comes with the mortar team and the MG42 team, which value-wise is really good. Now, a German box of infantry is also $48, much like the Americans. You build 30 guys. If you'd pick that up, you can go ahead and build two more squads of infantry. Now, for this army, we built one squad as veterans with MG44 or STG44s, give them a little bit more punch. The veterans come with two light machine guns for that faction. And then we would just build another squad of 10-man Germans with light machine gun and a sergeant with a submachine gun. All the squads with the veterans have Panzer Fausts, which you're going to find is a really good anti-tank weapon in this game. So it gives your infantry a lot of punch on the move. So the German build is actually a little bit cheaper because you can get a lot of the stuff in the support pack. So for the German, you're looking at upwards of either $299 or $266. That's if you buy the starter, and if you buy the starter, then it comes with the Hannah Mag and the troops in the rule book. Or if you just say, I'm going to buy them individually. The Hannah Mag's like $29.99, rule book's $40, their infantry box is $48. So if you don't plan on sharing the box with anybody, then you'll save yourself like $30, about $30-ish. Just like I said, for the Americans, you can go ahead and pick up the Colors of War in the German paint set. So when you're all said and done, you're looking at least $250. $280. If you wouldn't buy the box, and about $420 if you would buy the box. But you get terrain, dice, you can split it with people. What's nice about this if you would build it the first way we suggested, you have like 20 extra guys to play around with. Maybe drop your Panzer IV or your Sherman, add in more infantry squads. Because this primarily is an infantry-based game. And as you can see, here's 2,000, here is two 1,000-point armies. And it really fills up the table space. You know what I mean? So it's a fairly fun game. Usually plays within an hour and a half. Yeah, that's was one of our fun suggestions. We haven't got any videos up on the channel, but we're going to be here very soon. Hope this kind of helps give you guys a little bit of like an eye-opening how cheap some games are. Because obviously if you try to build 1,000 points in, say, Warhammer 40,000, you're easily double these numbers. But, alright guys, hope you liked the content. Have any suggestions for other videos we should do, go ahead and put them in the comments. Y'all have a great day, and thanks for watching. I guess here's a opening look at what the miniatures look like, just for you guys. Alright guys, hope you enjoyed the video. One of these times we're going to get these on the field for you guys to see. Alright, you guys have a good one.